worship. This morning we're going to begin by singing Days of Elijah. Join us as we praise our Lord.
Grace and peace to you from our Lord Jesus Christ, and welcome to this service of worship as we celebrate a very special Sunday, and you'll hear a little bit more about that from Maddie in a minute. As we gather, I have a couple of announcements that I'd like to make. First off, a special welcome to those of you who are here, especially for the Cross Trainers program. I want to welcome you to our sanctuary and to our service of worship, and let you know that should you require one, there's a bathroom in the back to your left, my right, and it's right back there. Also, if you are a person who likes to hold the hymnal, the middle hymn today is one I bet nobody knows. And so there's hymns on the bookshelves right behind the back row. If you're a music person and you want to follow those little things, this is your fair warning to get up and grab one of those at some point. Terry's got one, and Susan just grabbed one too. I want to apologize to anybody connected with the youth group mission trip because it became apparent to me today that I am a liar. The permission slip that I sent out insisted that all participants be here at 9:30 this morning for a special time of commissioning. That commissioning got crowded out by the cross trainers thing, and I didn't say anything about that. So I apologize if you're a youth group person who got up early because Dave said you had to. I'm glad you're here, but you're off the hook for anything that's happening today. Also, people going on a youth group mission trip, the permission slip says to be here at the incorrect time. The folks at Faith Ranch asked us to come after dinner. So pay no attention to the time on the permission slip. We're meeting here at 6:15 so that we'll get there after dinner tonight. So, and we'll just meet down on the Clare Haven Street side. And please, youth group folks, remember to bring a water bottle, sturdy shoes, and swimwear, and a towel, else you'll be left out of some stuff. I think that's all that I have for announcements. Do we, Barb, do we have any word on rescheduling that pool party yet? Okay, so the pool party was canceled on Friday because of all that thunder that we had, so we will look for a time to reschedule that. I'm going to introduce Maddie, who has been a leader in our cross trainers for 4 years? 3 years? Probably sometimes it seems like four. Come on up and tell us a little bit about this morning's service of worship and anything else you'd like to say about the camp.
All right. Hello, everyone. My name is Maddie. I was the lead counselor here at Cross Trainers this year, and the service today is going to look a bit different. We do have some of our campers here as well as some of our staff, so they're going to be reading some of our scripture. We're going to sing some songs from camp, so we're all really excited to be here, and we're excited to have you here. Our camp this year, we had close to 60 campers, which is almost double the number that we had last year, so we were very excited to bring those numbers in. Our camp, we have three groups who go through three rotations of Bible, art, and rec classes, and this year we introduced a fourth group, and I just want to give a shout out to Miss Grace, who led our fourth group, and she did it so wonderfully. And we're very excited to have brought that group in. I did speak here about the halfway point of camp. I know I talked about some of the field trips that we went on. Since then, we have gone to Urban Air, the Pittsburgh Zoo and PPG Aquarium, and this past week we went to PNC Park. I just wanna give a thank you to everyone who supported our staff this year, who supported our campers. We're very appreciative of everyone who signed up for the meal train and got to feed us while we had conversations about what was going on at camp. So thank you all for that. And just thank you for being here. We're excited to hold this service today, and we're excited to see another successful year of cross trainers. Thank you.
Friends, I'll invite us all to stand as Sonny comes up to lead us in our call to worship.
The call to worship. The good news is this. Pain and suffering have limits. We are not lost. The poor are loved. Resurrection is real. Our world has other news, bad news. Babies die. Parents grieve. Poverty grows. People blame others. Violence occurs. Between the good news and the bad news is the presence of God's people. We are called to let light illuminate darkness, to elevate joy over gloom, and to struggle for truth to dispel evil. We are here to worship God. Let us be God's people today.
I know. Please join me in the prayer of confession. God, forgive us for being asleep so often when you need us. You writhe in the agony of the world's hungry while we worry over the menu. You weep with the soul of one who is friendless while we fret over whom to invite to some social occasion. God, forgive us for sometimes taking our children, your children, for granted, and not hearing their special needs, for not loving them as you require. Wake us up to the needs of our sisters and brothers everywhere. In Christ's name we pray. Amen. You are a chosen race, a royal priesthood, a holy nation, God's own people, in order that you may proclaim the mighty acts of him who called you out of darkness into his marvelous light. Once we were not a people, but now we are God's people. Once we had not received mercy, but now we have received mercy. People of God, all of us together have received God's mercy in Christ. In Christ, we are forgiven, redeemed, and made to be a community united in faith. Thanks be to God.
The prayer for illumination. God, the Bible is a very special book. It is so big and so old. What do these old words mean for our lives today? Please send your spirit so that we understand your word. Amen. The first reading comes from...
I'm going to interrupt just for a second. Before Sonny launches into the first reading, we should have made clear earlier, I apologize. You have 6 scripture readings today, very brief scripture readings, each of which is a weekly theme from the 6 weeks of cross trainers. And our camp emphasized these teachings, and so you kind of get the nuggets of these coming out. I apologize for interrupting.
You're good. The first reading comes from Ecclesiastes chapter 4, verse 9. Two are better than one because they have a good return for their labor.
The second reading, Proverbs 27:17, as iron sharpens iron, so no one sharpens another.
The third reading, 1 Peter 4:10, Each of you should use whatever gift you have received to serve others as faithful stewards of God's grace in its various forms.
The fourth reading, Ephesians 4:32. Be kind and compassionate to one another, forgiving each other, just as in Christ God forgave you.
Wait a second. Who's missing?
Fifth reading, John 8. We
ought
there before, before the show hospitality to show people so that we may walk together for the truth.
The sixth reading, Romans 15-5. May the God who gives eternity, endurance and
encouragement
give you the same
attitude
of mind towards each other that Christ Jesus had. This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. I'd like to have all of the cross trainers who are here to come up. We're going to do a little singing right now. This was one of Pastor Dave's favorite parts of camp, was singing. Come on right up here, Jimmy. Here you go, guys. Over this way. Come over. Over this way.
Okay. Here we go. Hi, everyone. My name is Hope, and a few of you may know me, but for those who don't, I used to be a cross trainer a few years ago, and it was what I looked forward to every summer. Although I grew out of being young enough to be a cross trainer, I took a 2-year break, and this year I decided to become a CIT thanks to my sister suggesting it. My sister had been a counselor for a few years, and before that she had been a CIT too. She knew I was bored this summer since I'm unable to do the activities I usually would due to a foot injury. So she suggested that I become a CIT this year. I started around the 3-week mark, and I am so grateful that I did. Even though I was late to volunteering this year, I've become so close with the kids. Learning each of the kids' names was a struggle, but once I did, every morning I would greet them at the door and put a smile on their face, or at least some of them. I started to help with group 4, but I ended up moving to group 1 a few days later. Helping little kids is something that I love to do because I have 2 younger cousins, who love to hang out and always want to be with me, so helping other children is something I enjoy doing. I have formed so many close relationships with the kids, and I've learned so much from them and being here in general. We have done so many activities, such as Water Day, Career Day, going to Urban Air, the Science Center, Relational Time, and many more. The first field trip I joined them for was the Science Center. I had still not gotten to know most of the kids yet, but they still came up to me and asked me questions and wanted to be around me. There was one little girl who was not in the best mood, but once she was happy, she wanted to hang out with me for the rest of the day. This was one of the first times I had spoken to her, but she talked and wanted to be around me like I'd known her from the start of camp. Seeing how excited the kids were to do these things gave me so much joy and gave me a sense of purpose of being here at this camp. After the week had ended, all the kids were talking to me, and I started to speak and get to know all the kids. Learning about them and knowing how much of amazing people they are and had made an impact in my summer. I really hope that I made a difference in their summer with talking with them and doing fun activities on Wednesdays and Fridays with them, as well as relational time. Knowing the kids would keep these memories for as long as they can remember and making a difference in these kids' summers meant a lot to me. There are so many things I have not mentioned, and I could go on and on of all of the memories I have made, but that would take a very, very long time. Volunteering at Cross Trainers is the best thing I could have possibly done this summer. I really hope I've impacted the kids' lives because they have for sure impacted mine. Thank you.
Hi, my name is Jazera. This is my 6th year participating in Cross Trainer. Each year I come back because I enjoy the fun activities and getting to know people in my community. Every the years, I have also learned in Bible how to get trust others and trust in God.
That sound is feedback. It's okay. Start it, just back up a little bit. Where were you on your page? Let's just start here, over the years, and just stand a little closer to this.
Over the years, I have learned in Bible how to trust others and trust in God. I have also learned how to be a good friend. The summer theme was We Are Stronger Together. During week 4, we learned about forgiveness. At first, I believed in you only had to forgive someone 3 times or not at all. But I know now Jesus must forgive all the time. The Bible said, love keep no records of wrongs. This has been an important lesson for me because I don't hold on grudges anymore, and just instead I let go and forgive, and or for the strength to multiply when we are together, we must be forgiving. Cross Trainer is something I am very grateful. I still remember my first day here when I was 5 years old. I felt real shy, but then a staff member included me to other kids, and I was able to become their friend overall. And this camp made me more outgoing, and I make more friends every year. One of my favorite things about camp has been art class. From it, I have learned how to make slime. I have also learned how to clean up after my messes, where I learned how to because that was something I always didn't. I have also loved rec, it where I learned how to swing a bat, a baseball bat, and play other sports from rec. I have learned how to be a good team player. Other parts of camp I always loved for is other field trips. The past summer we went to Urban Air and I got to do a backflip off of the trampoline. A worker then told me, if you don't know how to do a backflip, don't do it. But I did a backflip anyways. The open doors have gave me the confidence to always take chances and put myself out there.
Last year was hard for mostly everyone. COVID, COVID was one of the most worst things that could happen to probably lots of people here. This year was different though. This year we had more of a relaxed and free schedule. My year at camp was better because I got to be closer with my friends, helped out people in my community more, and overall got to do things we wanted to do. This year at camp has been a blast with new adventures like going to the historical museum, hearing things I've never heard before. I truly am gonna miss this time here at camp, and I hopefully can come back and have another great summer here. I wish everyone a happy, healthy, and safe school year coming.
Hi, I'm Julia Immler. This was my third year working at Cross Trainers, and this past summer I had the great privilege of being the Bible teacher for the second time. And I want to start by expressing the gratitude I have for all of our outstanding staff and for everyone who supported Cross Trainers in any way, whether that was prayers or providing meals for the staff. When thinking of our mission statement for Cross Trainers, it says, "We exist to improve the lives of the neighborhood youth through programming and an environment of safety and fun." With confidence, I can say that as a team, we absolutely accomplished this. The overall theme of the summer was we are stronger together, and I believe the teamwork among the staff is proof that our strength truly does multiply when we come together, because none of us could have ran this camp on our own. While reflecting on my favorite memories from this past summer, I would say it's all the moments when we were able to go above and beyond that mission statement, the moments that provided more than just fun and safety, but the moments when God spoke through the staff and those words resonated with the children. Towards the beginning of camp, it was a day after lunch, and a girl from group one picked up a broom and began sweeping. And after I thanked her for doing that, she said it was because she was taught here to be a good helper. And ever since that moment, I kept seeing her want to help and whenever she could. And then there was another time we had a woman come in. She was doing puppet shows for us. And she had asked the kids about forgiveness. And one of the boys from group two, he raised his hand and says, 490 times. And like seeing him trying to quote like some Bible scripture I had said about how Jesus said, you know, we forgive 70 times. It just was like such a special moment for me because at such a young age, he understood forgiveness, but also understood it's something we do endlessly. Overall, there were so many times I got to witness the campers apply and practice the themes they were taught in Bible, but then there were also times they taught them back to me, had to remind me of them. For example, we were at the zoo on a field trip, and two of the boys, as they're looking at the elephants, one of them asked if I could carry his water bottle around for him, like, the whole day, and, like, I want to say no, but then he looks at me and is like, well, aren't you the one who taught us to be kind and help our friends? And I was like, I did say that, that's true. So I did, I ended up carrying it for him, and it just that's something I won't forget because it reminded me on how like I can be a better friend and how slightly going out of my way goes a much longer way for others. Ultimately, all the moments like these are why I continue to come back for another year. It's watching the kids grow their confidence and learn how to be better helpers and friends. It's seeing the kids' inspirational creativity and their ability to recognize their gifts to use for good, whether that's a girl using her talent of writing to share a poem about what she learned from camp at this talent show, or whether that's campers using their artistic gifts to draw pictures for the people they love. In the end, it's God's will and the camper's growth, kindness, and what they teach me that make me love this camp so dearly. Each camper is so sweet, and I have so much love for all of you. And there was a moment at camp, like a few of the kids from group one, Jimmy was one of them, on their way from rec, they like picked me flowers and like put them on my desk, and I have them at home in a frame now, and it just reminds me like of their kindness and everything. And I just want to say thank you so much for an incredible and memorable summer, and thank you campers, because it wouldn't be a camp without the campers. Thank you.
Next will be the hymn about which I warned you. It's number 487 if you have a purple book. And I will invite you to use this as your prayer for these kids. Let's stand and we'll sing this together. That last verse up there, isn't that a wonderful? Please be seated. Sharon, would you skip back one verse? Isn't that the prayer? Julia mentioned the Cross Trainers mission statement, but isn't this a prayer that echoes that? Surprise them, God. We serve a surprising God who leads us into wonder, who guides us with gentleness. So this is our prayer for the kids that we have known and those whom we have yet to meet. We come now to that time where we are, as God's people, able to share our joys and concerns, to talk with each other about the things that have gotten us up in the morning or kept us up at night in the week that we have just had. I have a few to share with you. Happy to tell you that Virginia Chopek is at home, resting and healing after prolonged treatment. Also at home is Hannah Ostland, our seminarian, who has finished her travel in Peru and Malawi and Mexico. She is back in North Carolina resting up, and she'll be here at the end of the month ready to start another year of youth group. You've seen the Cross Trainers. We're excited about that, and I would encourage you to meet some of the staff after worship. I'm also delighted to be able to say this in person, but Tuesday is Florence's birthday, and Florence is in worship today. And so that's a good day, and we are glad to see you, Florence. We have had some folks who have had a tough time. Want to pray with Sean Black. Sean is here this morning, but Sean's dad, Jamie, died this week, and we had a funeral service, and we want to extend our sympathy to his family. Also, Ben Veltman's mom, Glenda, Peter's wife, died in Grand Rapids, Michigan. She will be remembered here at a memorial service on the Saturday of Labor Day, which is the 3rd of September, and that probably will be around 11 o'clock that Saturday morning. Peter himself has been in and out of the hospital. He's not able to be with us, but is with us in spirit, and we want to pray with him as he works towards recovery. And also our friend Eleanor Arlette. Eleanor will go in tomorrow and receive a pacemaker, and she asks you to be in prayer for her. That's the list that I have in front of me. Are there other things of which I ought to be aware? Yeah, Connie. Okay, and your first name, sir?
James.
Prayers for James going through some treatments. Okay. Janet? It's always a good Sunday when you can hold a baby, huh? All right. Sharon?
Peter is online, so that's a good sign. And there also is a comment in the chat from Malcolm Knight just thanking the church for the presence in the community, and we are very blessed to have cross-trainers.
Well, we're glad for that. Shout out to Lindsay's dad there. Okay. Season.
Yes.
Prayers of joy for Hunter's 10th birthday coming up this week. And prayers that the situation might work out for Eliza's transportation. Eliza's in the process of shifting schools, and there are lots of moving pieces. And Susan, I'll tell you that I have reached out to some of the area pastors, and I have a lead on a family I can talk to you about. Rach. Those online would not have been able to hear all of what Rachel said, but a wonderful affirmation of our cross trainers ministry and a prayer that it might continue in the days ahead. Anyone else today? Let's then continue and pray. Surprising and wonder-filled God, we give you thanks for the opportunity that we have to be together today. Thank you for these young voices that bear witness to your movement in the world, and for those who have guided them through the summer, whether they have done so by being in the classroom and working with them and taking them on field trips, or they have sought to provide that by means of sharing a meal, bearing encouragement, and praying for the staff. We give you thanks that you have been present with, in, through, to, and for the campers this summer. And we do pray, as Rachel said, that you would bless these seeds, that they might bear fruit that will just continue to grow in the days that lie ahead. We pray for the open door And we ask that you would increase our capacity and our ability to serve the children with the love of Jesus and to be bearing witness in the families in this neighborhood. Similarly, we lift up our preschool ministry, and we ask that that sister ministry, if you will, might be one of anchor and blessing for families in this community, that children might hear from an early age of the ways that you surround us with love, invite us toward joy, and beckon us to wander in your grace. We pray for those whom we have named today, those who have traveled and have returned home, those who are able to be in worship for the first time in a long time. We are grateful for birthdays to celebrate, for school years that begin. We ask your blessing on those who are in grief, and pray for healing power to come into the lives of those who have suffered sickness or some form of unwellness. We know, Lord, that in our congregation and in our community, there are things that are so hard to even name out loud when we want to talk about praying together. How do we talk in prayer about evils like racism or betrayal or families that have fallen apart? How do we pray for our friends who live with addiction or who wonder if there's any point to it? We pray for those who are experiencing mental illness and ask that you would bring great grace and peace into their lives. We lift up our young people as they prepare to travel to Faith Ranch this evening. We ask that you would give to them safety and wonder and joy. We pray that in the encounters with the various job prospects and horseback riding and other surprises that are there, that they might know more of your grace and peace and joy in the world. We pray for our nation and for this world that is at war. We ask that your church might be a vehicle of peace, that we might bear witness to your calling to live gently and kindly, as the kids have said today, and that in so doing, we might be a part of the healing that you intend for this creation. We pray these things and so many more in the name of Jesus Christ, who teaches us to pray together, saying, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts, as we forgive our debtors. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever.
Jesus invites us to reach out in friendship, even to those we might not normally consider. Speaking through a story, he said, I tell you, whatever you did for one of at least of these three brothers or sisters of mine, you did for me. As you respond to God's outstretched hand of friendship today through the returning of your offering, be thinking about one or two persons you may not know very well, to whom you might this coming week reach out and exchange some meaningful conversation. Give yourself to the world that God loves. The plate will not be passed to collect the offering. You are encouraged to place your offering in the boxes mounted at the back of the sanctuary now or as you exit today. Those who are worshiping online will find instructions on the screen. And we now have a video showing some clips from throughout the summer of Cross Trainers, so you get to see some of the stuff we did with the kids.
Celebration. I'm getting a video.
Wait, wait.
Cross trainers is that we went to the urban air.
It's the field trip.
The field trips.
My favorite thing about camp is whenever we made the stuffed animals snails.
Wreck and field trips.
Everything.
Art and wreck.
I'm hanging out with my friends.
My favorite thing about this camp is probably urban air. Chocolate milk.
Meeting new people and making friends.
We played murder.
Fashion show and talk to the police officer.
My favorite thing about camp is art because I love to draw and paint and sculpt.
All the field trips.
My favorite thing about camp is rec.
Begin.
Rec.
Favorite part of camp was making all my friends.
The field trips.
Bobby.
My favorite thing about camp is rec.
Art.
My favorite thing about Cross Trainers is the Pirates game.
Fridays.
The pool.
The open door.
Favorite thing about camp is all the field trips and all the staff.
Field trips.
The Dave and Buster's.
Darion.
Cucumbers.
Fun size you.
The field trips.
Art and play at the open door.
The field trips.
When we went to urban air.
Probably the open door.
Cold
Science Center.
And the flowers in the garden.
Art and rec.
My favorite thing is to do art and Bible.
Do field trips.
When we cook pasta.
Making stuff?
Yeah.
Field trips.
On to urban air.
In class with Mr. Door.
What it? Urban air.
The field trips.
Everything.
Before we close out, I'm going to offer the prayer of dedication. Father, we thank you for everything that you have given us. We thank you for the opportunity we're able to give back to you, that which you've given us. We thank you for opportunity to serve others around us, and as you have blessed us, help us continue to bless others as we continue to give to those who are in need and those who are need our help around this community, and also in the city and around the country, Father. Thank you once again for this opportunity. In Jesus' name, amen. Before I share the closing thoughts about cross trainers, I might have Megan come over, and she wants to share a few things as well.
Many of you know me. My name's Megan Veltman. I'm on the steering committee for the Open Door. We are just so thankful for the staff and for the CITs because, you know, this is a ministry of our church, but without the staff, we would not be able to pull these summer camps off. So thank you so much on behalf of the steering committee and behalf of our church community. We are so grateful for you. And after church, I have a small token of our appreciation for each of you, CITs as well. So please come see me when church is over. Thank you.
As we close out, just give a few closing thoughts about the summer. Throughout the summer, and as I was sitting here, one word came to me. I think it sums up what we all experienced, and the word is transformational. I've seen it throughout years past during cross changes, even through the summer, that a transformation took place, not only in the campers, but also the staff, and I suppose myself as well. Transformation took place in this building, in this community. But that word transformational really hits home about what we do as cross trainers, what we've done over the past years as cross trainers, that we are here to transform the lives of the youth in our community here in Crapton Heights. And I was able to see it firsthand. Many of your parents, guardians have probably seen it too, when kids come home from camp and throughout the summer, how their lives are transforming into a better person, better individuals as well. I want to take this opportunity to thank the parents for allowing us to pour into your kids, to trusting us to send your kids to camp, and allowing us to pour into them, transform them, build relationships with them, eat with them, play with them. And I just want to thank you for supporting us as well as for the summer as well. Also for the campers, those that are here represented, we had, again, close to 60. Our goal as we were planning cross trainings was 60, and I think we had 58 or 59 registered on the roster. Any given day, we averaged between around 50, 45 to 55 on a given day with all the vacations and times off and different things. But we had a good number of great campers here. And I want to thank the campers that are here allowing us to pour into you as well. We thank you for those who are available to come back every day for us to do what we do. And I appreciate you trusting us to build relationships with you. So thank you for supporting us as well. And also for my wonderful staff, it goes without saying that any successful organization, any successful team, business, you cannot do it without good staff under you. And this staff this year really made my job easier, better, funner. Is that a word, funner? It is now, I said it so. Any team you play, you gotta have good players, you gotta have a good staff in order to be successful. And this team this year had 11 staff. And then this year, last year we had one CIT, and this year we had 7 CITs come through at various points of the camp. Even for them to volunteer their time to come out and to share and to help out was a blessing as well. But I want to say kudos to the staff. You really made the summer successful. You really made a difference in the lives of the kids as well. And I really appreciate all your efforts this summer. And thank you for allowing me to supervise, to oversee you as well. And also the word trust comes along. And what I did this summer is kind of build a framework of what we wanted to do for, for each class for the summer. And within that framework, I gave them the freedom to be themselves, gave them the freedom to express themselves, gave them the freedom to make decisions, gave them the freedom just to be themselves. And that's the way I like to lead, like to operate, is to give them the freedom to be themselves. And it worked, and it happened. And because of that, I saw transformation in them as well. Some of them came out of their comfort zone. Some needed a little push here and there. But I create a lot of opportunities for them to do better and be better as individuals. And I've seen that throughout the whole summer. So really appreciate your sacrifice. Not too often you hear college students, high school students give up their summer, 6 week summer camp, summer to come to camp and to work early in the morning to sometime late in the day. But they really sacrifice a lot this summer to be a cross trainer. One of my slogans, and I've always said this, is once a cross trainer, always a cross trainer. And thank you for being a cross trainer this summer. So thanks. Thank you everybody who supported us. Continue to keep us in prayer as we transition into Friday Night Rec through the Open Door beginning of September and carry that throughout and then return once again next summer for another exciting adventure with Cross Trainers 2023. Thank you, appreciate it.
This is a song that we first learned in the African nation of Malawi. And if you don't know it, here's the main words. Can you say Palibe?
Palibe.
Ofananaye.
Ofananaye.
Saza.
Saza.
Peze.
Peze.
Kanso.
Kanso.
This is a song about Jesus. I've looked every place. I can't find anybody who's like him. There are some movements, and you'll see. The first movement is I've looked everywhere, I've walked everywhere, I've turned all around, and I've searched everything. It's kind of like when you know the remote control is in the cushion someplace, and you're lifting stuff up to try to find it. So this is Palibe Ofananaye.
Oh,
support the weak, help those who suffer, and honor all people. Love and serve the Lord, rejoicing in the power and the presence of the Holy Spirit. And may the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ and the love of God the Father and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with you now and forever. And let the whole church say,